Within Word, click on the View ribbon and then click on Outline. You will learn that you have many different levels of headings that you can put in. By default, it starts at a heading level 1, and I'm going to call this the working title to just get this from the final project proposal. When finished typing my heading, I can press Enter at the keyboard to move down to the same level heading, and I could demote the heading to a level 2 or return it to a level 1 by using the arrows up here. There are a number of ways you can do this, but I've moved back under Statement of Purpose. I'm clicking Enter on the keyboard, and now I will indent in one level and start populating ideas under my statement of purpose. You would then continue populating the outline with the terms and ideas that make sense for the work you're doing. Here I'm trying to do a literature review, and I want to keep the categories in mind that I want to go to the literature for. And so I've put in some of the standards, some of the ideas about project-based learning, curriculum design. If a level has no further information under it, you'll see the minus sign. But if this level, for example, has information below it, you'll see the plus sign. Once you've got in enough headings, you might want to close the outline view and notice that you actually have the formatted heading levels that would print once this became a large paper. And that's not particularly useful at this point. So let's go back to View and then go back into the Outline view where the indent levels help us understand what we're doing. I'm going to put in some text to illustrate the next point. For any area where you want to add text, you click up to that particular title and then you move down to the section where you want the text. Let's say I want to add information to the statement of purpose, so I just clicked Enter and it's now waiting under another level 1. I'm going to turn that to body text by clicking that arrow. It now has a slightly different icon there, and I'm just pasting in some text that I created as dummy text. So now this text does not have a heading level, it's body text. With the added mocked-up text, I can decide to go up and maybe show only the certain levels. Let's show only 2 levels. So I'm not distracted by the extra text, and I can see the organization of the information. Maybe I want to show 3 levels. Maybe I want to show 4 levels. I can even ask to show the levels and the first line of text so that gives me a little bit more information. A key feature here, though, is being able to move things. Supposing you've decided, though, that you want the standards to come later, and I'm just showing my level headings. If I click this X, I have all of the items under the standard, and the text beneath it will move together, and I can go up to either promote it up or move it down some levels. I'm going to just, for argument's sake, move it down, and I'm going to be careful here. Let's say I want to move it all the way down so that it resides just before curriculum design. So I'm going to bring the project-based learning up ahead. All of the sub-areas came along with it. Now, if I simply wanted to move something within just one sub-area itself, I highlighted the Meet Professionals. Let me just move that up within this area. You want to be careful so that you bring your text with you, but it's a lot easier to rearrange a paper when you have things in this outline form. And as you flesh out the parts, let's now close the outline view. And this time I went and put in some text so you could see that the headings make more sense when you have some text within it. But by going back to View Outline, you can look at the organization and structure of your ideas and more quickly and efficiently create a logically organized paper. When you're using the outline function, be sure to understand too how to change the headings to the style that you want and how to generate an automatic table of contents from these headings.